I raised the Black Pearl from the brine deep, and you were her captain for 13 years. Now, you owe me 100 years servitude.
I'm thinking all that water may have addled you a bit. By my recollection, our bargain was for 100 years as captain and 13 years of service to you, David
Jones. I appreciate your amusing attempts to wriggle off my hook, but I recall the terms quite clearly. Tis a standard contract. Everything ironclad and legally sound.
Ah, a pirate and a barrister. Seems like a duplication of efforts. But a deal is a deal. Better not have mishandled my other effects. Shouldn't you be guarding something? Empty. Pity. Finders can't be choosers. Against one. Guess I'll fight one handed.
You want to fight?
You want to fight?
these.
You wanna fight?
These coffins into the sea before they start to stink.
A pirate looking toward longevity avoids patting himself on the back too often. So many of us have hooks after all. Yet I think my escape from that nasty prison may be worthy of a line or two in a memoir. That, and it put me in sight of the pearl. Bootstrap Bill Turner, my old shipmate. Is that you?
Tis indeed, Jack Sparrow. But sorry I am, your time is up. Davy Jones has sent me as his emissary. You're called to service upon the Flying Dutchman.
That ship already has a captain, so there's no need for me.
That's what I feared you'd say. Now you've heard the story, so you know what happens next. Jones Leviathan will find you and drag the pearl back to the depths and you along with it.
Any idea on when Jones will release said terrible beastie?
I told you, Jack. Your time is up.
The Kraken, a creature of dark legend, and the occasional ode, snaps at my heels. So, upon spying an uncharted island, I grounded my beloved Poe and ordered the crew to seek out supplies. However, they've yet to return. It's been a night and a day, and it crosses my mind. Perhaps they've abandoned me to my death. No, there's only one way to know for sure. Find them and ask them. With my gizzards properly steeled, I ventured forth. My good man, you didn't happen to see any... No. Wherever did you find such colorful feathers? Charming decor. Good use of color. So practical. Doesn't seem entirely safe. Nothing to worry about, just like the pile's rigging, only green. Come on. Not ones for hospitality, are you? Possibly find somewhere a touch safer to kill each other.
Thank you.
Is it? On second thought, damn it. These wretches were notably impressed by Captain Jack Sparrow. Yet, it was only after they made me their chief that I realized the reasoning was less to do with my adornments and more to do with the circumstances in which I'd encountered them. Spying the various crown skulls about, I wondered just how many chiefs they'd eaten prior to my illustrious reign. I knew time was running out. My hosts had left little doubt about their plans. Then, my salvation appeared in one Will Turner, who miraculously arrived with some leftovers. I mean to say, my leftover crew. Young Turner signaled he had an escape plan in mind, so it was up to me to distract my loyal subjects. Now, mimic a chop, garnish myself with parsley, brandish my rations. From chief to fugitive, and not even a trial. The Saab's giving a jump, eh? Won't be a problem.
Ah!
chew on that, but not
from me.
Without marshmallows. Wherever did you find such colorful feathers?
You, Jack Sparrow! Just as Elizabeth and I were about to be wed, we were arrested for aiding a known pirate. Because we saved your thieving hide, our chance for happiness is ruined.
Will. There comes a time when you have to take responsibility for your mistakes. Of course it's a shame about Elizabeth being shackled in a filthy, rat-infested cell and all, but I've got a bigger problem. I'm cursed, which you are not. Now, I need to find the key on this cloth to free myself, savvy? And the witch Teodoma is the only one who can help. So if you want my aid in saving your damsel, you'll do something for me. She couldn't choose a nice speech, could she? No wonder I haven't encountered anyone alive here. No, don't bother getting up. I'll let myself out. Just like swinging across the rigging to plunder a helpless vessel. If it was a house, in a swamp, with no plunder. What are you doing in there? You don't even eat. I thought they smelled bad on the outside. I'm not fighting until you've washed up. To anyone below, my apologies for the racket. They buried you a little deeper. Oh. Besides it, this is clearly not the place to be. Thank you. Teodorma, I'm in need of your help.
Asking for help does not sound like Jack Sparrow. What service may I do for my old friend?
This key. I've got to find it. Don't suppose you could tell me whereabouts to look?
I could. But as you know, dear Jack, I demand payment. Fetch me the lost amulet from the tomb of the Lady Dunsmore.
Now, love, how about a little hint as to where I should start looking for said lost amulet? I've not much time and...
Jack, there's a reason they call it the lost amulet. But if I were you, I'd look in the graveyard for the largest, darkest crypt of all. It should be in there, somewhere.
If I were a shiny little bauble, where would I hide? How long will this take? I'm quite pressed at present. Definitely wouldn't want this to fall into the wrong hands. I'll be taking that. Thank you. Sorry, mate. I'm sure you understand. I suppose some dead men do tell tales. Thank you. last. I knew this place was built by a pirate. Finders can't be choosers. Sorry, mate. Necessity is a mother. Prize is within reach. Thank you.
Jack, it's beautiful. But you shouldn't have.
Don't seem to recall having a choice in the matter.
I have what you need, Jack. The answers. David Jones locked his heart away in the dead man's chest. If you had the heart in your possession, he would be powerless against you and the curse would be broken. But to open the chest, you need the key. The key he keeps with him at all times.
Ah, clever. What say you tell me where I can find said Jones?
The Flying Dutchman is not far from here. A terrible shipwreck, do not. David Jones, he'll be there, recruiting. There's one other thing, Jack.
And that would be?
Take this. It will keep you safe.
We soon arrived at the place. It had to be. Betwixt the stench and the overgrowth, it was perfectly clear Davy Jones was nearby. I decided to pursue the key all by me onesies, leaving Will and the crew reluctantly behind. I'm ashamed to say I knew the lad would follow me, but I'm sure you understand, it's not as if I had a choice. Best just get this over with. This ought to get their attention. Huh? be rattled. The taste of salty perspiration is but an appetizer to taking to the sea. Definitely wouldn't want these to fall into the wrong hands. Thank you. appreciate what you're trying to do, but do Mate a favor and stop! Sea turtles around the moon. I wasn't kidding. This stuff will kill ya.
Yeah.
Flying Dutchman? She doesn't look like much.
Neither do you. Don't underestimate her. Now then, what's your plan?
I row over and search the ship until I find your blasted key.
Splendid. And if you do get captured, just say Jack Sparrow sent me to settle his debt. Might save your life.
Now you don't think that lad's soul alone will take the place of yours, do you, Jack?
Perhaps not, but I'm certain he'll grow into the job. What say you? We have a deal?
As has been the case before, I'm oddly compelled to listen to you. I'll take the lad's soul as a good faith payment. Bring me 99 more souls to make it an even 100, and I'll consider the debt settled.
Ah, Tortuga, the likeliest place to find lost souls. If only they knew they were lost and thus were interested in joining my crew instead of challenging the great Captain Jack Sparrow. I suppose that's the price paid for fame.
Thank you.
Are you sure you wouldn't rather fight each other, mates? Too long now. Of course, not too short either. One silver lining? Elizabeth? You know those clothes do not flatter you at all.
I've been looking everywhere for Will. I see it in your eyes. You've seen him. Where is he, Jack? Please.
Through an unfortunate series of circumstances that have nothing whatsoever to do with me, poor Will was press-ganged into Davy Jones's crew aboard the Flying Dutchman.
Devil take your ghost stories, Sparrow. The Flying Dutchman indeed. Certain to frighten young children and fools. Excuse me while I scoff.
Commodore Norrington, why, you really look terrible. So nice to see you.
Former Commodore Norrington, I lost my commission, my life, when you escaped me last time. I've nothing now, so I might as well turn pirate. What of it? Am I worthy to serve under Captain Jack Sparrow? Or shall I just kill you now?
You're hired. Glad to have you aboard.
James Norrington?
Where to, Captain?
Plan B, it would appear. We'll make our course for East La Cruza, to Davy Jones' chest. And no arguments, Elizabeth. This is the only chance we have to save your bonny lad.
I hear a heartbeat! This is the chest!
So it is.
Will, I didn't expect to see you again so soon.
Bootstrap Bill, my father, helped me escape. But not before I got the key. Now I'll open the chest, destroy the heart, and free my father from his imprisonment.
And I suppose you let Jones here as well, eh? Might selfish of you, mate. If you kill Jones, his beastie will never quit.
Well, I want my life back, and taking this chest will give me the bargaining chip I need to get it.
I know what I must do.
The prize is mine. No head start this time, Captain Sparrow.
To the wrong hands.
I should kill you for what you've done.
Oh,
traitor! How you repay me? You'll have to take it from me, Jack.
My life, I'm taking it back.
Jack, will you never fight fair?
Lovely.
Pirate!
Thank you.
my father. He was your friend. We need to destroy it.
I'll be taking that.
One pirate, you've met them all. Scoundrel! You filthy cur. Surrender, and I'll consider not bringing you back with me in irons.
I've beat you once. I can do it again.
Thank you.
insufferable streak of honesty has to run out eventually. Hand it over!
Crew! To the shore! Defend the dead man's chest! And bring me Captain Jack Sparrow! Our business is as yet unfinished.
That's a very nice trick, appearing out of nowhere and all. Underneath all that, I bet you're really quite dapper. Some clever woodworkers on this island, probably eunuchs.
Yes. You're between me and that Shimoff that your captain was ugly.
Seems my troubles are over. Perhaps I spoke a wee bit hastily.
I'll take that, if you don't mind.
Norrington is drawing off Jones's crew, and he has the chest!
I wouldn't worry about that. While they're off getting acquainted, I suggest this is an excellent opportunity to board the Pearl. Split up!
Ugh!
Why not? The more, the scarier.
What are you doing now? What are you doing now? What are you doing now? What are you doing?
I'll be taking that. lot better be the last. Got places to be and people to steal from. Out of the way. Why not? More scarier. Thank you. One part perseverance. Rest in peace, I insist. Why not? More scarier. Yeah. rather dry, fellow. I'll be taking that. Wanted one of these. Thank you. but you lot better be the last. Did you think you'd best me? I'm Captain Jack Sparrow.
Thank you.